It was the last week of the first academic semester and both Atsumu and Ikora are having a bad day. Ikora hit a snag in therapy. His doctors underestimated his injury. His knees couldn't take the stress of the next step and they've taken a few steps back. He should be happy, he thought. He'll have more time to spend with his friends and family, with Iwa-chan. And he is. Happy that is. He's also a bit frustrated. Atsumu on the other hand, keeps on failing the new technique he's trying to make. That and the fact that he failed one of his tests and he's been forbidden to step into the gym until he passes it. He has to retake the exam on the first week of vacation and if he still doesn't pass that, he will be spending the entire summer vacation attending remedial classes. It's probably why when Saturday came, both of them grabbed a few beers on their way to the twins' apartment. Sometime in the middle of the night, they went to the nearest convenience store and bought stronger liquor. They became each other's confidant. And with every drink they consumed, more of their problems came pouring out. You know, I think deep inside me I realize that this isn't healthy. That being with Oni's changing me somehow, and not for the better. But what am I supposed to do? I can't leave him. I can't. If I could, I would have done it already. But I don't think I can take the pain of losing him. This is painful. Yes. But the thought of breaking up with him hurts so much. Sometimes I wish I don't love him. That I've never loved him but then he smiles and I can't help but be thankful that he's in my life. I think so too. Sometimes that maybe it would have been better for us to have remained as friends. I wouldn't have expectations then. I just don't get it. I mean I do but. It still hurts you know. Was it too much for me to expect that my best friend turned boyfriend act more like a boyfriend than a best friend who only really checks in once in a while? Am I being selfish? Is it too much to ask for my boyfriend to be my boyfriend? Am I being too narrow-minded? You're not selfish. I mean you can't be, right? I mean, he's your boyfriend after all. There's nothing wrong with demanding a little bit of attention once in a while, right? Or is that wrong? Do we have to be more understanding? How much more understanding should we be? I don't want Oni to leave me if he's ignoring me then there must be something wrong with me, right? Do I have to give him more space? But I miss him so much. I miss Iwa-chan too. But he's busy and I don't want to be a bother. But can't I see him? Even for a bit? I don't want to leave him. I want to stay with Iwa-chan. But he doesn't. He doesn't want to stay with me. And I want Iwa-chan. I want him here. Is that too much to ask? Atsumu shook his head as he drew in a shuddering breath. He didn't answer because he couldn't. There was nothing he could do but choke on his tears as he tries to breathe. The thing is, neither of them thinks they can breathe properly without their boyfriends, the love of their lives, with them. Both Atsumu and Ikora cried themselves to sleep, the holes in their chests as evident as the bottles that littered the floor around them. That was how Tendao and Ashijima found them in the morning. What the hell? Tendao studied the scene in front of him. The bottles that littered the floor, the cold pizza that laid forgotten in its box, the still playing movie on the TV, and last but not the least, the creepy still bodies of his best friends on the floor. He would have thought they were dead if it weren't for the soft snores coming from their direction. He analyzed the situation once more and still couldn't comprehend it. Ikora and Atsumu were bad bitches but they were never fond of liquor considering Ikora can't even stand coffee flavored milk and Atsumu has strict teammates. So, the fact that they got drunk was unbelievable, but the evidence was undeniable. What the hell? Tendao whispered again. He looked at his boyfriend calmly standing behind him then turned his eyes back at the bodies of his friends on the floor. What the hell? He shouted, no longer able to contain his disbelief. The bodies on the floor twitched. Further proof that they were, in fact, alive. Tendao breathed a sigh of relief. Before H realized once again, the situation he was in. His best friends are dead drunk on the floor. His best friends, who absolutely can't stand bitter stuff, are dead drunk on the floor from alcohol. Bitter, piss-tasting alcohol. Yeah, he's gonna need some help. What the hell? That's what I said. Osamu had both his mouth and eyes wide open, surprise breaking through his calm facade. Even Suna was slightly wide-eyed. Atsumu and Ikora are still on the floor. No sign of waking up. Osamu closed his eyes, pinched his nose and let out a breath. Yeah, we're gonna need more help. Kita blinked at the scene in front of him. The others just watched him nervously. He turned back to them and all of them stiffened, except for a Shijima who has absolutely no social awareness outside of the court. So let me get this straight. Tenda found them, called Osamu who had time to shower, change clothes, eat breakfast along with Suna who did all of those things too. Probably not at the same time as Osamu did. Then you both traveled from Suna's house to here, called me, and I did all of those things you did, walked here from my house, and with all of that time, none of you, absolutely none of you, thought to wake them up, or at least clean up a bit, even if just to pick up the bottles on the floor? No, Kita sighed. He wanted to be calm and collected as always, but these kids are testing his patience. Kita sighed again and began picking up the bottles before waking the two problem children up. He doesn't care that Oikoa is the same age as him. Otherwise, he might just use the bottles to do something he will regret, or might not regret. They have a big field and he had once heard that humans make for very good fertilizers. After they were done cleaning up, Osamu and Suna went to the kitchen to prepare lunch while the others were left in the living room to wake up the dead. The dead had a hard time waking up, in fact. They would have preferred not to wake up. Their mouths were dry and tasted like what they imagined licking sand wet with pee would taste like. It hurt to open their eyes due to all the gound that formed throughout the night. After they removed all of it, they opened their eyes to the sight of a disappointed Kita, an unamused Tendao, a confused Ashijima, and amused yet concerned Hanamaki and Matsukoya, who arrived during their cleanup. It was evident by their puffy eyes that they were both crying. What happened? My head hurts. That's the hangover. Hangover? What? Don't you remember almost drinking yourselves to death? What? You two drank enough alcohol to make an entire volleyball team including bench warmers and coaches drunk. Oh. Yes. Oh. What were you thinking? Atsumu and Oikoa thought back to last night. Their first adventurous sips that made them want to hurl. To the point where they stopped caring about the taste and craved the burn more. They remembered the first problems they shared to each other with whining, only half-serious voices, to bawling their eyes out as everything came spilling out. Both started crying while the others panicked. For as long as Matsukoya and Hanamaki knows Oikoa, they've never seen him cry. Seriously at least. The only time was when they lost to Karasuno. They've known him as the dorky, determined and incredibly strong captain. So seeing him now, crying his heart out, almost sobbing is alarming. Vulnerable was a word they never though they would use to describe Oikoa, but it's the only word fit to describe him now. It was the opposite with Atsumu. The others were used to him crying. He cries about the smallest things sometimes. He cries when he's happy, frustrated or angry. He would cry out crocodile tears while whining or shouting about what caused him to cry. This Atsumu in front of them though, was different. He was absolutely still, staring at the floor in silence as tears fell down his face. None of them know what to do. They wanted to comfort them but they didn't know how. They never had to comfort them before. Why are you crying? Ashijima, confused as ever and not reading the room tension, spoke. I want Omi here. But he doesn't want me. Iwa-chan doesn't want me too. If he does, he wouldn't have turned me away every time I try to talk to him. He doesn't love me. He probably regrets dating me. But they're your boyfriends? Yeah. So? Confused baby Ashi. Just break up with them. Osamu yelled from the kitchen. No. Samu. I can't lose Omi. Scowl all you want. Nobody can see you. But I don't want to leave Iwa-chan. Then what do you want to do? I dunno. I hear vacations make you happy. Weren't you going to Okinawa next month? How do you know that? Tendao told me. Where are you going with this? Why not just go now? I can't. I have an exam to retake. Number. It makes sense. Let's go this week rather than the last week of vacation. We'll have more money now compared to when we go later. And you two need to get away from your air quotes boyfriends for now. But I have an exam. Kita-san, would you be able to tutor Atsumu? Sure. Great. It's Sunday today so Kita-san will tutor you so you could go take your test tomorrow so it will be fresh in your mind. We'll go on Tuesday. But. The only but I wanna hear is your butts going to the bathroom to take a shower. You both stink. So you're going then? Shut up, Ashitjima. Eternally bitter Oikoi. Shut up, Wakatashit. The enemy of my friend is my enemy, Adzumu. Okay, Oikoi and Adzuma. Follow the trend, Ashitjima. Adzumu and Oikoi squawked. You both deserved that. Unamused Tendao. Dots dots, okay, fair. Sorry. Fine. Sorry. Apology accepted. Now get you butts into the shower or I swear to God I will. They ran. Kita-san, can you come with us to Okinawa? Yeah. I have nothing to do anyway. Wait. What's this about going to Okinawa? Osamu asked as he entered the living room. Oh, the bottoms are going to Okinawa for a week long, hopefully longer, vacation. Including Tsumu. If you want to believe that Adzumu tops in that relationship, I mean relationship. I'm sorry, typo. Typo what? Then you're entitled to have your own delusions. Okay, one. I don't think of my brother in a sexual relationship. Ever. Especially with that kelp looking fucker too. Why are you going to Okinawa with my brother but not me? He's my brother. And you're going there to comfort him. Why can't I come? And three. Typo what? You're talking out loud. I didn't know you bottom. I don't but. Then you can't come. But Kita-san can? He's not even in a relationship. Wow, Samu. So mean. Yes, Samu. So mean I wasn't. Wait. Does this mean Suna's coming? Oh yeah, definitely. Sunarin. What? Why didn't you tell me you were going to Okinawa with my brother without me? You make it sound like we're having a sordid affair behind your back. Oh my god, please no. I don't need nor want that image in my head. I need brain bleach. Maybe I should ask some from Sakusa. He's useful for that at least. Maybe I can bleach his face in the process. Shooketh. Shooketh. Aroused Suna. Confused baby Ushi. That's a great idea. Scared. Scared. Mildly concerned Suna. Still confused, still baby Ushi. Maybe I can ask Osamu for the body. Sakusa's tall. He could fertilize a lot of plants. Would the bleach affect the plants though? Anyway. Back to the topic before I get further tempted. Why didn't you tell me? Oh. I don't really check my messages. I just saw it now. Tendao. I'm in. And Samu. I'm going to Okinawa with your brother, but don't worry. We don't have a sordid affair going on behind your back. There will be other people with us. Please stop with the sordid affair thing. It's disgusting me. I repeat. We have no. If that's your way of asking for a threesome, then maybe I could convince Tsumu. Ha, bitch, you thought. Regretting all life decisions. Bad bitch Osamu. Kill me. Kill me. Kill me. To hear without ears. I am confusion. I still don't get why I can't come. This stubborn bitch. This stubborn bitch. In the bottom baddies group chat, hey babes. Hey babe. What's up? So you guys know about that vacation to Okinawa that we were supposed to have on the last week of summer vacation? Yes. Yes. I can't wait for it to happen. Why are you asking about it? Is it gonna be cancelled? What? No. Why? Relax, bitches. We're not cancelling it. Then what? Rather than last week, we're going on Tuesday. Not that I'm complaining, but why? Done with life, done with life. Oh, I smell tea. Not so straight is online, unholiest one is online. Tea. Tea. No tea. At least not new tea. Then why are you sharing it? And why is it affecting our trip? We found our organizers almost dead drunk. Wait. Really? That's surprising. It's really funny how those two act like cool bad boys when they're the least rebellious. Lol, I know, right? Suga's more likely to become a stripper than them. I'd make a good stripper. We know that and we love you for it. Well, what happened to them? Air quotes boyfriend problems? Also done with life Yaku. Of course. What else is new? Forever done with life Tsukishima. So what's the specific problem? We don't really know. We just found them the morning after they drank enough alcohol to get us all drunk. Wait, what? Yup. So we're going early to comfort them before they drown themselves in alcohol. So pack up, bitches. I'll be in charge of buying the tickets. You can just pay me back after. Lol, who said anything about paying you back? You know, Kita's still searching for excuses to make human fertilizers. I could probably convince him you'd be good match. Less hair, less work after all. Understandable, have a great day. Not so straight is a fline. Kita's doing what? Nothing unless you piss him off. Note to self. Do not ever mess with Kita. Note to everyone. Noted. Wait. Is there someone here who can't come, since it's on such notice after all? Oh right, for those who can come say I. Curler is online, Shara Boo is online, I. Everyone's coming then. Great. Imar, notify the ones offline and the girls then. It's the night before their trip to Okinawa and the twins are packing. Osamu was able to convince the others to let him come, or more accurately, he was able to convince Kita to convince the others to let him come. I don't like this. Samu, if you didn't want to come then you don't have to. You weren't even supposed to come in the first place. Osamu pouted. Of course I want to come. Then start packing and stop complaining. HMPH. I don't like this. What's this? Samu, the reason we're going to Okinawa. I hate that you need to go somewhere far away just so you could get away from your air quotes boyfriend. You make it sound like I'm running away from an abusive husband. Aren't you? Omi's not abusive, Samu. Abuse isn't just physical, Tsumu. The fact that he's not physically or verbally abusing you doesn't change a thing. Neglect is a form of abuse too. Atsumu swallowed through the forming lump in his throat. I'm not breaking up with him, Samu. I can't. Osamu sighed. He wanted to convince Atsumu, but he knows Atsu's not yet ready. He knows that Atsumu would choose him over Sakuso any day, but he won't force him to make that choice now. He wants his brother to be happy, and if being with that bastard will make him happy then he will let it be. Until the day Atsumu realizes he doesn't need Sakuso. That doesn't mean he won't try to hasten the process though. He will get Sakuso away from his brother. If that means rekindling the flame that Kita and Atsumu once had, then so be it. Give me your phone. What? Why? You're taking a break from your air quotes relationship. You can't spend the entire trip to Okinawa waiting for his messages. But what if Omi texts or calls? Then I'll give you your phone. Atsumu opened his mouth to ask something but decided not to in the end. Unfortunately, Osamu saw the action and read his brother clearly. And if he doesn't text or call, then why would you want to be with someone who cares so little about you that they don't even notice you gone? Or even if they do, won't do anything about it? Atsumu bit his lip to stop himself from crying. He's in this relationship just as much as you are. You can't be the only one doing their part. Reluctantly, Atsumu handed his phone. He doesn't know why, but this feels like a test somehow. And he's not sure if he wants to know the answer.